Space is infinite, it's there to explore.
Our vision is millions of people living and working in space.
One's got to fantasize and dream about these things.
If we're going to continue to make progress and make sure that our descendants have better lives than us, we need to go to space. It's not optional.
Jeff Bezos, the founder of Blue Origin, and Richard Branson, the founder of Virgin Galactic, are in a head-to-head race to travel to the edge of space. In June, Bezos announced his plans to travel to space on July 20th, along with his brother, as inaugural passengers on Blue Origin's new Shepard spacecraft.
I really want you to come with me. Would you?
Are you serious?
I am. I think it would be meaningful. I have my brother there.
Weeks after Bezos' announcement, Branson unveiled plans to travel on Virgin Galactic's fourth crewed spaceflight on July 11th, just 9 days before the Blue Origin trip.
This July, our dream will become a reality.
The important thing about having both the founders go up is just the validation.
So, two billionaire founders, two trips into suborbital space just days apart. But the two companies and their missions have big differences. Let's begin with the spacecrafts and their flight plans.
Galactic is much more akin to going up in a commercial airliner. Blue Origin's New Shepard rocket is much more the typical view of what a space rocket looks like.
Virgin Galactic's planned flight begins near Truth or Consequences, New Mexico, where this mothership called the VMS Eve will take off with a spaceship attached called the VSS Unity. At an altitude of almost 45,000 feet, the airplane will release the spacecraft, whose pilot will rocket the vessel into suborbital space, eventually reaching over 50 miles high. This is the altitude that NASA defines as the edge of space. The flight will carry two pilots and four mission specialists in the cabin, but no paying passengers. And the approximately 90-minute trip will end after the craft glides to Earth, making a runway landing back in New Mexico. Now, onto Blue Origin, whose New Shepard spacecraft is slated to launch from West Texas on its first crewed flight. The vessel, which can travel at three times the speed of sound, includes a rocket and a fully autonomous six-person capsule. Approximately 3 minutes after takeoff, the capsule and the rocket will separate. The rocket will then return to Earth, deploying drag brakes to reduce speeds by half while the capsule travels briefly above the Kármán line. This is an imaginary boundary, 62 miles above sea level, that is commonly defined as the beginning of space. It's approximately 12 miles beyond the high point for the Virgin Galactic flight.
Practically, there's absolutely no difference between 50 miles or 62 miles or indeed the surface of the moon. Humans couldn't survive in any three of these. There's a little bit of bragging rights, but officially, you're an astronaut if you go past 50 miles.
The Blue Origin capsule will float back to Earth via parachute, landing in the West Texas desert approximately 10 minutes after launch.
At the top of that arc is where the passengers will actually be weightless, and it's just going to be for 2 or 3 minutes. Now, from the companies, they both say passengers will be allowed to unbuckle the seatbelts and float around the cabin for those 2 or 3 minutes.
Because these flights are suborbital, they're regulated differently than commercial air travel. Congress agreed in 2004 to let the space tourism industry self-regulate to speed its preparations for passenger flights. A spokesperson from the Federal Aviation Administration said its jurisdiction is limited to protecting public safety and the environment during launches and re-entry.
With Virgin Galactic, the FAA has to inspect and approve both the mothership and the rocket ship, and it licenses the pilots. Blue Origin is different, that it's a more traditional space rocket. The FAA's oversight of rockets is actually, very different and evolving. It's more self-regulation, but it doesn't actually need formal approval. The formal approval it needs, just like Virgin Galactic, is to carry paying passengers.
The FAA granted approval for Virgin Galactic's full commercial space launch license, and the company says it hopes to launch commercial service next year. Blue Origin has applied for similar approval from the FAA, which it expects to receive by July 20th. Aside from Branson, passengers on Virgin Galactic's flight include Beth Moses, the company's chief astronaut instructor, and Sarisha Bandla, a vice president focused on government affairs and research. The company has yet to disclose prices for its future commercial service, but executives have said trips could cost less than $500,000. The passengers on the Blue Origin trip will be Bezos, his brother Mark, Wally Funk, an 82-year-old pilot with space training.
It's the best thing that ever happened to me.
And the winner of a charity auction, who bid $28 million for a seat.
Sold $28 million!
As the missions themselves vary, so too do the milestones these flights achieve. If all goes as planned, Branson will be the first of the two founders to go into space, while Bezos's Blue Origin will be the first of the two companies to carry out a spaceflight with a paying passenger.
Virgin Galactic is basically a pure play space tourism business. If it's safe enough for the charismatic and well-known founder to go up and come down safely, then you know that will certainly help the brand.
Two.
With Bezos and Blue Origin, slightly different motivations. The validation that they've managed to put someone, or in this case, four people, to the edge of space just helps the broader Blue Origin business, which isn't just space tourism, it's government contracts and military contracts. So for both companies, it's a huge validation that they've arrived and that they can use this as a springboard for the next stage of their different businesses.